Non più trai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tu a dolcino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tu a dolcino d'amor.
Hey guys, it's Teresa and welcome back to my channel. I wanted to start by saying that I hope everyone is doing well and that you are safe. So today I wanted to do a little fun video, a different type of video for my channel. I'm going to be talking about Italian fashion versus USA style differences. And a little disclaimer before we begin the video, I am not a fashion expert. The information I'm going to be sharing with you today is simply based upon what I've observed during traveling to Italy since 2015. I believe that I am pretty accurate with the information I'm going to be sharing with you. Those of you who are from Italy that are subscribed to my channel, I welcome your comments in the comment section below. If there's anything that I am sharing that is not accurate, or if there is something that you would like to add to this video, please leave it in the comment section below. So let's jump right into the video. Italian fashion is some of the best in the world, and the Italians take great pride in the way that they look and dress. And when they dress, they are more concerned about the balance of the colors that are within their outfit. The Italians have more of a neutral color palette, like black and white, navy blues, dark brown, and gray. In American fashion, we tend to dress for comfort. If we are not going to a wedding or to church or to an event or to a dinner date, we tend to dress for comfort. So here in America, we are not necessarily concerned with the fashionable things that we wear every day, unless it is an event. We are more concerned with being comfortable. So let's begin with the shoe differences in Italy and America. In Italy, sneakers are extremely popular, especially white sneakers, and they are worn with any type of outfit. Whether it's a suit, a dress, or a pair of blue jeans, sneakers are very popular in Italy. And one of the reasons is because there are cobblestones, and it is very difficult to wear a heeled shoe like a stiletto on cobblestones without getting injured. In the USA, we don't normally wear sneakers with dresses or suits. We typically wear some type of heeled shoe or some type of heeled boot with our dresses and suits. And we save the sneakers usually for the gym or for blue jeans or for just running out to do our daily errands. However, in Italy, sneakers are extremely popular and they are very stylish when put together with the Italian outfits. In fact, on our last trip to Italy, I purchased a pair of Italian sneakers and I absolutely love them. I paired these sneakers with a dress while we were going on a wine tour in Florence, and it was extremely fashionable. So it allowed me to have something different to wear and just to be able to pair together a different outfit with a pair of sneakers. And not only was I very comfortable, but I felt like I could blend in with the Italian fashion. So the next Italy versus USA style difference I want to talk about is office attire. Italian women normally dress for the office so that they can go straight from work to an aperitivo and then straight to dinner without changing clothes. However, they may change their earrings or a necklace or even change the purse they are carrying to work. But the clothing that they put on for the office is normally styled in a way that they are prepared to go straight from work out to dinner in the same outfit. The difference here in America is that we usually dress one way for the office, say a pantsuit or a particular dress for office attire, and then we would normally come home after work and then change into a different outfit, something like a little black dress, and maybe change our heels, our jewelry, and sometimes even the way we wear our hair, and then we would go out to dinner. The next style difference is athletic wear. The Italians do not wear their gym clothes to the gym. They wear their normal stylish clothing to the gym, and then once they are in the gym, they change into their gym clothes. And after working out, the Italians will change back into their stylish clothes before going out on the street. So they are looking presentable when they go to the gym and when they leave. They only wear gym clothes to the gym. Here in America, we wear our athletic wear to the gym, and we also wear it from the gym. So we do not normally take a specific outfit with us to change into at the gym unless we are leaving the gym going to work. We normally just throw on our gym clothes and head out the door. And I am not saying that there is a right way or a wrong way to dress in this video. I am simply sharing with you the style differences from Italy versus America. Next, going to the beach. When going to the beach, Italians only wear flip-flops at the beach. You will never see them walking around, going to the market, going to the shops or the restaurants in flip-flops. The Italians reserve flip-flops for the beach and the beach only. You might see an Italian walking around in something like a gladiator sandal, which still looks very well put together with their outfits. Here in the USA, we tend to wear flip-flops with pretty much everything, especially in the summer. And I've also seen people wearing flip-flops in the winter, you guys. Just saying. We wear flip-flops anywhere, whether it's a dress, blue jeans, shorts, and I've even seen people in suits and flip-flops here in America. So we do not typically reserve flip-flops for the beach only. We see flip-flops as something to quickly slip our feet into and head out the door, especially if it's in the summertime. The Italians have a rule of no more than two, maybe three colors top for an outfit. And those colors are usually neutral colors like black and whites, tan and gray. The next style difference I want to talk about is vacation attire. In Italy, Italians are still very stylish and very well put together, even when going on vacation, by complementing their outfit with something like a nice hat and maybe some gladiator sandals. Here in America, we are more likely to dress for comfort when going on vacation, styling our outfits with something like a baseball cap, blue jeans, baggy shorts, or maybe even something like a sundress or even some gym shorts. We are more likely to dress comfortable when we are going on vacation. And of course, we're either going to wear some sandals or some sneakers or flip-flops. So these were some of the style differences that I thought you would enjoy knowing about. And be sure to stick around for my next video, because since we are home together, we are watching a lot more TV and a lot more movies. So my next video is going to be about my favorite Italian movies. So if you haven't subscribed, please go down below and subscribe to my channel. And please give this video a big like, a big thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.